Welcome to the Vicis Interimo 30 Minutes to Kill podcast.
You are listening to the Vicis Interimo show, 30 Minutes to Kill. More or less. The incredible podcast with the unpronounceable name. We are a horror entertainment podcast featuring mostly spoiler-free discussions of horror, suspense and psychological thrillers. I am your horror host, Michael Mad Saxon Jones, here with my lovely wife Lori. The show is usually broken up into four parts. Laid to Rest, where we tie up loose ends from earlier shows. Followed by our featured movie review. Garbage In Garbage Out, is where we talk about anything we have watched, seen online or even read since the last show. Lastly, we always try to end the show with a crawling chaos. A topic or factoid we have never talked about on the show before. Sometimes silly, sometimes serious, but always chaotic.
Welcome to episode 310.
Where am I?
You're here in the Bag End Studios, where we are now recording our newest episode.
Yay.
You are listening to the Vicis Interimo show, 30 Minutes to Kill, More or Less, a horror entertainment show featuring suspense, horror, and psychological thrillers. You can find us on iTunes, Stitcher, and Podomatic, just about anywhere. Type in Vicis, V-I-C-I-S, I-N-T-E-R-I-M-O, Vicis Interimo. I am your host, Michael Mad Saxon Jones, here with my lovely wife and co-host, Lori. Hi, Lori.
Hi.
Happy to be back talking to folks again after such a long hiatus.
Heck yeah.
We generally have four segments to each show. Laid to Rest, where we recap any old shows or information that we may have missed. I wonder if I'll throw your paradox story in, or whether that will be at the end of the last episode. We review a movie, a featured movie review. Featured?
What?
I don't know. I shouldn't be laying down recording, should I?
No.
Armistice.
You're not laying down.
On this couch that we have, I feel like I'm slipping
into... couch.
I feel like I'm slipping into it.
I think we should buy some bean bags.
Maybe. A
couple of beanbag chairs.
Armistice. That's the movie we're talking about.
Okay.
All right. Garbage In, Garbage Out. We'll talk about any TV, movies, or books that we've caught over the last week or so, or since the last episode. And then we end with a crawling chaos, a topic or factoid that we have never talked about on the show before. Sometimes silly, sometimes serious, most always chaotic.
Do you have one today?
I do. I actually have something else.
Every week you've been having a crawling chaos.
Isn't that amazing?
Yeah.
Let me check my notes and make sure I have something.
Yes, now that you've said that.
Yes, I do have something.
Okay, good.
You know what? It's another, well, I'm going to say lame. It's another video link. But it to me, it was funny, and it got me actually thinking about something. People get triggered. Okay. And they get upset about things. I guess triggered is the catchphrase, but that comes later in the show. Never mind. All right. So I'm going to take a moment because, well, first of all, I'll ask you, I know it's been a while, but was there anything that you wanted to cover since the last show?
Oh, are we doing the Laid to Rest segment?
Yeah, we're doing the Laid to Rest right now. If you listen, you'll hear the music.
Oh, I see.
Shotgun blast, actually.
I wasn't here for that.
Okay.
You'd think I'd have heard a shotgun blast.
You think so?
Let's see. Our last episode, I don't think I have any loose ends.
Do you remember what we talked about last time?
I think I do. We did a review of the movie Here Alone.
Yeah, okay.
Yep.
And we talked about paradoxes. We talked about Gary Newman's show and him still being alive, though he hurt himself.
Oh, poor thing.
Yeah. Well,
he's been touring since summertime or before summertime. He's been doing it almost every single night. He is a ball of energy. But yeah, it was
on a very small stage with a couple other balls of energy.
Yeah,
well, at least one anyway.
So unfortunately, those balls of energy collided. Luckily, it was after we saw him, so we saw him in fine form. Some of the shows that came after that, though, I don't know. I follow him on Facebook. It's kind of cool because he and his wife, you know, they maintain their own page, so you get photos and little bits that they write on there, but. Okay. Yeah, his foot was wasn't pretty.
Yeesh. Well, let's see. We talked about that last week or last time, and we also talked about the 1984 Sherlock Holmes that we Jeremy Brett that we watched.
Oh, you finally discovered the.
Well,
the
I discovered that last time, but oh, yeah, just in case we didn't cover it then.
Right.
Yeah. Anyhow, Armistice. That's what we're here to talk about.
Yeah. Let's just get into the movie right now.
Okay.
This is old stuff.
My name is Lieutenant Edward Sterling of the 12th London Regiment. I have been trapped inside this awful place for what feels like a lifetime. I fear I will never leave it alive. I write this for whatever man is next trapped in this prison. And I truly pity you, my friend.
I'm going to start by saying armistice. Am I saying that right? I don't know. It's a formal agreement of warring parties to stop fighting. It's not necessarily end the war, since it only may only constitute a cessation of hostilities while attempting to negotiate a lasting peace, but it's derived from the Latin arma, meaning arms, as in weapons, and stop.
Okay.
Meaning stop. Oh. Yeah. You know, I'm all about Latin words and stuff. That's why I named the podcast.
Yeah. Great.
Great. Stuck with that for the time being anyhow. Yeah. You know what? Let me get to...
Okay. So that's what armistice
that's
is.
That's what it means. But here, what... tell me what it is we watched.
Well, this movie is from 2013. And like last week's movie, this one is also not rated, interestingly enough. Okay, with no recollection of how he got there, Royal Marine A.J. Budd finds himself imprisoned in a nightmare where survival depends on endless killing. As he searches for a path of escape, Budd lives each day under siege by savage, inhuman foes.
Okay.
Isn't that interesting? Because that synopsis makes it sound like that's the main part of this movie, him surviving an attack every day. It's so much more than that. That's just a little piece of it.
Really? Okay.
It was to me.
Oh,
But the trapped... Ah, dang. There's the phone.
I'll pull out the Lady Gaga.
Ugh.
Up on me. Sorry, I cannot hear you. I'm kind of busy.
So,
I have no idea what we were talking about now.
That's okay. We'll first get into the fact that...
The synopsis pretty much just said this guy is trapped in a nightmarish house where he has to fight a monster every day of his life.
Right.
Is that what it was about?
Felt like... See, this is a tough one for me to talk about because I want to say... Do we want to spoil this movie? I'm going to start at the end and say, would I recommend this movie? I would not recommend this movie to anybody. That sound awful?
You wouldn't recommend it to anybody? Like, just zero recommend. Don't waste your time.
You know, because there's like three movies that I want to list, and every one of those movies that I list would, I think, ruin this movie, because I don't think it was anything original. Or...
Okay.
You and I...
It was not original.
Okay.
But at least as it was going, we were... I was invested enough to wait and see if we were right as to what was happening.
I was absolutely willing and invested enough while we were watching it, too. And I wanted more and therefore was disappointed. Now, having said all that,
well,
everything in the movie was good.
Yes.
But...
It was very much like a Twilight Zone episode.
Okay.
Like a short story.
Okay.
That was what it really reminded me, like, probably 20 minutes in or something, my mind was like, oh, this is a Twilight Zone story.
Okay. There's that.
I've seen it before. I don't think it was on Twilight Zone, maybe on Night Gallery or, like,
Night Gallery, Outer Limits or something
Outer
else.
Outer Limits like, or, yeah, you know, you've seen this story before.
There are feature-length movies, again, I don't want to ruin it for anybody if they do want to check it out, but, like, this is an hour and 20 minutes that you maybe could have invested in something else, because whether it ruins it or not, I mean, it's exactly what we thought. Now, again, we've also talked about the fact we've seen a lot of movies.
Yes.
And other people haven't. So it's not fair maybe for us to judge or make recommendations by that. We're
pretty hard to, like, when it comes to twists, I am always so impressed when a movie has a twist that I did not see coming, because we almost always have at least a couple ideas.
Sure.
It's like, well, it's either going to be this or that. And then, well, it was that, not this.
We start narrowing it down. And
yeah,
it gets
I hate that.
Yes.
It's like, I want to be fooled. I want to reveal at the end where I'm going to go.
We want that aha moment. We want that.
Yeah. It doesn't even have to be a twist. I mean, I guess it was a twist. Sort of. I mean, it was a reveal more than a twist.
Right.
That makes sense. But yeah, I think if I knew somebody, like you said, who hasn't seen 8 million movies.
Yeah. Maybe somebody that's just getting into the psychological thriller aspects of movies.
Maybe. That sounds funny. Like, well, if I knew somebody who was gullible and can easily be fooled, I would recommend this.
I didn't say that. Those were your words, but okay.
That was what I felt like I was saying, and that's not...
Okay, okay.
That feels weird.
Yeah. Well, I'm still searching for that aha moment. It's ridiculous, but right. I want that aha moment of when I was playing Frozen Memories, the Silent Hill game.
Yeah. Is that what it's called?
Yeah. And there was a second where I moved a lamp in a room, and suddenly I realized that there was a telephone number appeared on a wall when I did that. Like, I want that kind of, oh my gosh.
Yeah, discovery.
That discovery
surprise.
Was exciting and stuff, and you didn't get this. Nobody's fault. Joseph Morgan was, I guess, the guy that was the actor,
well,
the Royal Marine.
He had to carry that whole
he
movie
He carried
himself.
Everything, absolutely.
Yeah, he was pretty great.
And... Yeah, there was nothing wrong with it. It just, like I said, I was let down because the story was...
Would it have been better as a half-hour Twilight Zone episode? Did it need an hour and a half to be stuck in that dang house?
Well, that's what we get to, and this is what you were talking about, the fact that there's more than that, because once you've determined how to kill the enemy... That becomes the easy part. It becomes the boredom. It becomes the monotony. It becomes...
I feel like that's what it was about. Not
hell
losing your mind.
Is repetition.
Yeah.
That's the definition of what hell is. For some people, anyhow. Okay.
Yeah.
We got to see that with when the TV show Preacher was on. There was that one whole episode where we got to relive somebody's version of hell, and it was a guy... Or Groundhog Day, even. Oh, see, I don't want to give a bunch of movies and give away. These things are not the ones that I'm thinking of that would do that.
Well,
but.
I mean, we were 10 minutes into this movie and you said, oh, Groundhog Day. I mean, that's not a surprise.
Okay.
Yeah, because basically, I mean, the guy, it says right there, he's stuck in this house and has to fight this thing every single day. Well, every single day, like clockwork, it's like you wake up and it feels like Groundhog Day all over again.
The movies that I can mention that don't have a connection to this is something like The Cube.
Right.